you're from. They thought he's going to say Nazareth or Galilee or Bethlehem. He says, I came down from my father. Not from a monkey, from my father.
Yeah.
See, it's powerful heaven. They said, what can you do? He says, with God, all things are possible. They said, where are you going? He said, I'm going where I came from, going back to my father. He knew every answer. Why did you come? He said, for this cause came into the world to be a ransom. He knew his purpose. Every human being watching this program, I tell you, you are not a mistake.
Come on now.
You are the image of God, and you don't need to dress up or be like anybody else. Be yourself. Jesus began his earthly ministry as a non-religious man with this statement. Blessed are those who are spiritually bankrupt, spiritually malnutritioned, spiritually poor. That's the way he began. And we call it the attitudes to be, you know. He said, blessed are those who are spiritually poor. He was talking to 6 billion people.
Come on now.
In Afghanistan, Iran, Africa, Europe, watching this program in England. He says, all human beings are spiritually poor. That means there's something in us that is starving spiritually, and every one of us know it. There's something, even the atheist is trying to fill that void with a belief that there is no God. See, an atheist has faith. Faith is the word belief. They believe there's no God. See, he himself, he's trying to make non-God a religion. Because we all got to find something to fill that spot. Listen to Jesus' conclusion. He says, blessed are those, that means happy are those who are spiritually poor and bankrupt, he says, because to you belong the kingdom of heaven. In other words, the only thing that can fill the void in the human spirit is the kingdom of God, the restoration of a relationship with the government of heaven, so that earth can become a colony of heaven and represent the culture of heaven on earth. You need to reconnect back to the God who created you.
That's awesome.
But explain to the people. I remember at times wondering, you hear the word kingdom of God, kingdom of, explain what that is to somebody if they've never heard it.
That's a very important question. I was born in 1954 in the Bahamas. When I was not born in a country. The Bahamas was what they call a colony. Only kingdoms are colony. And I was born under a king. The kingdom of Great Britain is over 600 years old. It ruled the Bahamas over 250 years. So we have a legacy of kingdom experience. So I know exactly what a kingdom is. And I lived under a kingdom until 1973. So when I pick up the Bible is fairly easy for me to understand because Jesus Christ was a king. He wasn't a president. He wasn't a prime minister. He wasn't a mayor. He was a king. So when I heard the word king and I read it, I go, I know what that is. When I hear the word kingdom, I say, I know what that is.
Right.
A kingdom is the governing influence of a king over his territory, impacting it with his will, his purpose, his intent, producing a citizenry of people who reflect the king's personal nature and culture. Let me repeat that again. A kingdom is not a religion. It is a governing influence of a king over his territory. It's called a domain. He impacts that domain with his personal will. That's why a king is different from a president. A president's personal will does not run the country. He has to consult with the Senate and with Congress and with the judiciary. But a king doesn't. His will becomes legislation. A king's will becomes the constitution. So when I use the term influencing his territory with his will, that's a kingdom principle. And he produces a citizenship of people who develop a culture that reflects the king's nature. In other words, in a kingdom, all the citizens end up acting just like the king.
Yeah.
Not see, in a republic or a democracy, we kind of pride ourselves in individuality. But in a kingdom, everyone acts like the king.
Wow.
They take on the king's culture, values, morals, and nature. That's why Christ says, how can you say you call me Lord and you don't do what I say? The
wow.
word Lord means owner. You say I'm your king, but you acting like someone else. So if you are in a kingdom, if a king says adultery is not in his nature, then every citizen don't commit adultery.
Wow.
It's not a matter of what you think anymore. It's a matter of if I'm in your kingdom, I'm supposed to reflect your culture.
Yeah.
So that's why we live the life of Jesus through us, because he is our king. And let me take it practical, Laurie, for the listeners. In the Bahamas, for example, when we were under the king, our kingdom drove on the left-hand side of the street. So when you come to the Bahamas, we drive on the left-hand side of the street. Our kingdom wear neckties and suits. In the kingdom where it is very cold 9 months of the year. But they didn't care. Once you are a colony, you dress like them, even though it's 90 degrees. So we wear suits and ties in 90 degrees. We have no snow. We have no cold weather. But our kingdom wears those clothes. So the colony wears the clothes. They take on the same reflection of the king. So here's what that means. Even if you don't want to live holy, if your king is holy,
come on now.
You gotta live holy.
Come on now.
I love it. You know, earlier in the show, you never did answer my question. Are you running for president? Probably
no,
not.
No, but I would advise those who are that they must align themselves with the government of God before they enter earthly government.
I know why that you're not running for president. You would run for king, though, wouldn't you? Yeah, you'd run for king now. If they had one of those going on, you'd...
But, you know, it's an amazing concept again, because under the kingdom of Great Britain, all my life, we were called subjects.
Right.
And we sang every morning to the king and queen. Every morning, we sang to them. We were called subjects. The kingdom of God is a strange kingdom. It's reversed. The kingdom of God is the most unique kingdom because all the citizens are family to the king.
Hmm.
Which means that everybody is like Prince Harry. Everybody is family.
Wow.
So we all got royal blood, and the king is our big brother.
Wow.
Secondly, that means all of us are automatically royal citizens.
Hmm.
Therefore, we are all kings.
Hmm.
Now, when a king has a child, if the child stays with the king, the child can never become king unless the king dies. So the king calls that child a prince. The word prince... Prince means first. That's what it means first. Say principle means first law. So it's called a prince or a princess. But if the king dies, then that child becomes king. The only problem with God is this. God is king. And he has children.
Come on now.
And he ain't never gonna die. Now watch this, Pastor Rick. Watch how good he is. So the problem with God is, as long as the children are with him, they can never be kings and rulers. They are all princes and princesses. So when you read the book of Revelation, it says that when you go to heaven, he says all the people who have died in Christ, they are prince and princesses with him. But the only way for a king, and I'm talking from experience, the only way for a king to have his son become a king while he's king, if he wants to be alive with him, he has to take that son away from his territory and put him in a foreign territory. This happened in Brazil, in Portugal, with Portugal. When a king takes his son out of his own territory and put him in a foreign territory, the son can become king also. So that person, that king, is now called a king of kings. Hmm. The first thing God did was made earth and then took us out of heaven. Put us in a dirt suit, put us on earth. He says, I have dominion down there, and I'm calling the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. So we are all kings in the earth.
I love it.
Part when the king visits his son in Portugal.
I like it. You go ahead, say it, Laurie.
Whenever daddy's king.
Yes, sir.
Right?
Whenever the king in a foreign territory goes back home to visit his father, he's no longer a king.
Hmm.
He becomes a prince again.
Wow.
So being away from your father is a better deal.
Wow.
That's why the Bible says, Jesus prayed. Jesus says, Father, do not take them out of the world. Why? Your authority is here.
Wow.
When you go back to God, you think that's wonderful. But actually, you just go back to God, and in heaven, they're doing nothing.
Wow.
It's down here where we are walking on serpents and scorpions and dominion over the power of the devil. This is where we get our power, man, on the earth.
Come on now. You know what is so exciting, and to prove that, You know, all you have to do is read the last part of the gospel.